The House Select Committee investigating the deadly January 6th insurrection, laying out its case that former President Donald Trump knew about the violent breach of the U.S. Capitol, watching the chaos unfold on television, and still waited hours to tell his supporters to go home.
President Trump did not fail to act. He chose not to act.
The day after the attack, Trump recorded this video, the panel playing outtakes showing Trump hesitant to condemn the rioters and unable to accept his election loss.
I don't want to say the election's over.
The committee showing White House logs with no official record of what Trump did while the riot unfolded. Witnesses testifying in the midst of the Capitol attack, Trump was calling senators to ask them to object to the 2020 election results.
Did you ever hear the president ask for law enforcement response?
No.
Former Trump White House counsel Pat Cipollone recounting multiple advisors pleading with the former president for hours to condemn the attack and call on the rioters to leave, and saying the president didn't listen.
And I said, you know, people need to be told. There needs to be a public announcement fast that they need to leave the Capitol.
Two former Trump White House aides, Deputy Press Secretary Sarah Matthews and Deputy National Security Advisor Matthew Pottinger, testifying live. Both resigned in the aftermath of the Capitol attack, describing how they reacted to Trump's response.
He should have been telling these people to go home and to leave and to condemn the violence that we are seeing.
The former president continues to lash out at the committee, calling their investigation rigged and one-sided. But Trump's inaction, the committee says, put the country at risk as the peaceful transfer of power was under siege. The committee announcing tonight they will hold more hearings in September after spending the next month gathering evidence. Committee Chair Benny Thompson, who has COVID and spoke remotely, saying there must be, quote, stiff consequences for all involved in January 6th, including the former president. On Capitol Hill, Jay O'Brien, ABC News.